I've been looking at the crashes on our county's roads. We want to eliminate deaths and serious injuries on our roadways.
Zero is our goal at the state DOT, and a safe system is how we plan to get there. Have you heard of the safe system approach?
Yes, we have a team working on the five elements of a safe system. I'm focused on the safe roads component. My challenge is the severe rural crashes. There are so many lane departures, and they rarely happen at the same location twice. It seems random. What can I do about that?
It does seem daunting. The Focus on Reducing Rural Roadway Departures initiative, or FoRRRwD, provides a framework for reducing these crashes, which account for almost 12,000 fatalities in the U.S. each year. That's 30 people on average every day.
Is FoRRRwD consistent with the safe system approach?
Yes. The FoRRRwD initiative is based on four pillars. These pillars support the six core principles of the safe system approach.
Sounds like just what we need. What are these four pillars?
Since you're working at the county level, let's start with the all public roads pillar. It's estimated that over 40% of fatal and serious injuries occur on roads that are not maintained by a state DOT. These include county, town, and tribal roads. This pillar reinforces the safe system principles that death and serious injury are unacceptable and that responsibility is shared among all agencies that own and operate the road system.
I agree. Eliminating all deaths and serious injuries is only possible if we solve the problem everywhere. At the county level, we share that responsibility, which leads me back to my earlier question. How do I address these rural roadway departures that seem to occur randomly?
Great question. That's where the FoRRRwD systemic approach pillar comes in. One of the safe system principles it relates to is that humans make mistakes, and that can happen anywhere. Identifying locations for improvements to reduce rural lane departures is challenging if you only use crash data. With a systemic approach, you identify roadway features present where severe crashes occurred and use those risk factors to review your entire system for similar locations.
So, curves may have risk factors like higher traffic volumes, lack of shoulders, steep roadsides, or fixed objects. And other curves with those risk factors are likely locations for future curve crashes.
Right. One benefit of the systemic approach is that it helps to prioritize locations for improvements even if there has not been a crash. This is in line with the safe system principle that safety should be proactive.
Sure, we definitely want to be proactive, but we have a lot of curves, and with the funding available, it would take decades to make improvements at all of them.
Remember, with a systemic approach, you only identify locations that have multiple risk factors, which may be a small portion of your system. Also, many of the treatments are relatively low cost. This brings us to the FoRRRwD proven countermeasures pillar. These include improvements that keep vehicles in their lane, reduce the potential for a crash if a vehicle does leave its lane, and minimize the severity of a crash if one occurs.
That's true. We can use rumble strips to help keep drivers in their lane. That works with the safe system principle that humans make mistakes. And so does adding shoulders at curves to reduce the likelihood of a crash if they do leave their lane.
Yes, and since humans are vulnerable, it is important to minimize the severity of crashes by using breakaway devices or guardrail where appropriate. Don't forget, these roadway departure countermeasures can be used in combination. That addresses the safe system principle that redundancy is crucial.
Wow, these FoRRRwD pillars really do align well with the safe system principles. What about the safety action plans pillar?
Developing a safety action plan is really just documenting the process used in the other three pillars and can incorporate all five elements of the safe system approach. It's consistent with the safe system principles of being proactive and that responsibility is shared. Action plans can be implemented at a statewide, regional, tribal, or local level. These data-driven plans help agencies communicate priorities and justify investment decisions.
An action plan would be helpful in communicating our process and getting everyone on the same page, and it might help garner support for funding requests.
The state DOT may be able to assist with data and funding improvements in your plan. After all, we both have a goal of zero, and a safe system is how we will get there.
Together, the safe system approach and FoRRRwD can help us keep people in their lane and safely on the way home.